by now, loyal viewer, of course you know the FANG stocks, but have you heard of the MAGA trade? Well, you probably have, but don't worry. It has nothing to do with politics. But Dan, he's been wearing the hat on that trade for some time.
And I just came up with this. We think it's pretty original. We're going to call it MAGA.
What?
We're going to do Microsoft, we're going to do Apple, we're going to do Google, and we're going to do Amazon. Those four stocks, MAGA, hashtag that, okay, M-A-G-A.
Now, that was all the way back in September of 2018. And since then, the MAGA trade has absolutely skyrocketed. So, Dan, congratulations. You coined a new acronym. Even, I think, the president is tweeting about this.
Yeah, well, so listen, Sully, what we did on the show is we made acronyms great again, okay? And so this one was really interesting. Listen, the point here was that those four companies, given the moats that they had, given the profitability, given the momentum, given everything you want to say, we all knew they were special, okay? But at that point in the fall of 2018, it became very clear to me that sentiment was getting a little hot on those things. Valuations were starting to pick up a little bit. And what happened? My view then was if they all trade together, then the market's going to follow with them. That is what happened in Q4 of 2018. But there's been other periods since, I think, the summer of 2019. They all started kind of trading together. Amazon obviously was a bit of a laggard. But just look at this year and look at the performance of the four names. They're all up between 10 and 18% driving a massive amount of performance in the S&P 500 at a time when there's a lot of headwinds to growth. There's a lot of headwinds to kind of owning equities and, you know, interest rates aside. So to me, I think you just really want to kind of stay focused on the concentration of it. I know, Tim, you think that obviously there's been ominous periods of time when a few stocks have a lot to do with a lot of the performance, that sort of thing. To me, that's really what you want to focus on.
Well, in fact, let's pat you on the back again. We talked about this. You talked about this in the fall of 2015 when we were seeing those same four stocks effectively be the leadership that was people running into capacity because global growth was very much in question. And, of course, the markets caved in the first 2 months of 2016. So I don't know if this is foreboding. Certainly these companies all just announced, every one of them, blew the cover off the ball as they announced their 4Q numbers. And in fact, they guided up.
But I wonder, Karen, if we learned something today, because bring up that graphic again, guys, where you showed half the MAGA trade was up and half was down today, right? We've pretty much split. You look at the market, that's what happened. The NASDAQ 100 was up 0.01%. Did we learn today, Karen, that unless all the MAGA stocks participate, it's going to be hard for the overall market to do anything?
Well, last night, if you happened to miss our show, you missed a really interesting Carter Worth segment, which was AppleSoft versus Amazugle, I think he called
it.
And how the Amazon-Google part of the trade was actually set to break out because Apple and Microsoft had already broken out so much. So that was interesting to me. And that's happening, or has happened, in the last few days. I think the run is getting a little bit longer.
What I'm saying, Guy Dami, is if Ma goes up and Ga goes down, or you know what I'm saying, if half go up and half go down,
can the broader market still rally to the extent that we've seen
over the last...
Or do
we need these four Clydesdales, which have been pulling that cart that Tim's been talking about, rightly so, can the market do
or it? Or can, to Carter and Karen's point, can two take the helm from the other two and still have this market? Dan is shaking his head. Let me mention this quickly. Microsoft traded 2 times normal volume today, made an all-time high, reverse close lower. That's something to watch. Now, 24 hours does not a day make, Brian, but if this continues, then you might have put in,
Doesn't?
No. Well, you know what I mean.
Let
me just tell you what's different this time right now. Okay, when you think of 2019, Apple gained 100% in calendar year. Earnings and sales growth were flat year over year. Their main product, their iPhone units, did not grow. So what was that doing? Their multiple doubled. Microsoft obviously had high single digits earnings and sales growth in 2019. But its multiple got to basically a record high in the last 15 years, trading 32 times or something like that. So that's what's different this time. I'm not even going to go back to 20 years. These companies did not have that sort of profitability or the moats or anything about it. But that's what's different right now. I think that 2019 pulled forward a lot of good news, especially as reflected in their multiple.